Short questions, short answers by Torah teacher Ariel and eBible. Copyright Tetzé Torah Ministries 2015. All rights reserved. Here's the question for tonight. Why did the Jews think they had eternal life? The passage in question is likely from the words of Yeshua Jesus. Let's read a passage out of the book of John. You search the scriptures because you think that in them you have eternal life, and it is they that bear witness about me. Yet you refuse to come to me that you may have life. That's John 5, 39 and 40. It is not wrong to think that the scriptures present eternal life to the reader and follower. After all, Shaul, Paul, wrote to Timothy about the Tanakh, the Old Testament, offering life through Yeshua. Let's take a look. But as for you, continue in what you have learned and have firmly believed, knowing from whom you learned it, and how from childhood you have been acquainted with the sacred writings, which are able to make you wise for salvation through faith in Christ Jesus. That's 1 Timothy 3, 14 and 15. And Paul spoke of justification, that is, salvation, for those who not only hear but do Torah in one of his earlier letters. Let's take a look at the book of Romans. For it is not the hearers of the law who are righteous before God, but the doers of the law who will be justified. That's Romans 2:13. Yeshua challenged the rich young ruler with this cryptic statement. And he said to him, "Why do you ask me about what is good? There's only one who is good. If you would enter life, keep the commandments." That's Matthew 19, verse 17. Moreover, the law, the Torah, alluded to its own internal righteousness when Moses stated, "And the Lord commanded us to do all these statutes, to fear the Lord our God for our good always, that he might preserve us alive as we are this day. And it will be righteousness for us if we are careful to do all this commandment before the Lord our God as he has commanded us." That's Deuteronomy 6, 24 and 25. So now we can understand why Yeshua would say what he did to those Jewish leaders. The problem with the Jews of Yeshua's day is that they were blinded by their own nationalism into believing they were, quote, saved, end quote, by being ethnically Jewish and by maintaining covenant faithfulness to the Torah of Moshe. Thus, they rejected any need for, in their eyes, an additional Messiah who would ostensibly cleanse them from personal sin. Don't misunderstand me. I didn't say the Jews believed that Torah obedience would save them. To be sure, I'm not saying it ever saved anyone. They simply, although incorrectly, believed that their ethnic identity as Jews would save them, i.e., quote, "We are sons of Abraham," end quote. Torah observance, then, was seen as the national duty of a Jewish person and existing covenant member who desired to remain faithful to the covenant. Thus, Jewish identity and Torah observance were two sides of the same coin. It is only the later emerging Christian church that likes to imagine that early Jews kept Torah because they thought it would save them. This caricature of merit theology is inaccurate compared to what we now know historically from the surviving rabbinic literature of the first century Jews and their preoccupation with covenantal nomism. So, in closing, I want to state as a Messianic Jewish man that there was and is nothing wrong with Jewish people, or anyone for that matter, keeping the Torah out of obedience to God and love for one's fellow man, even after coming to faith in the Messiah. What is wrong is when your ethnocentric Jewish exclusivism and zeal for Torah blinds you to the true Messiah found therein. Check out my podcasts, which are available on iTunes. You can search for me in the store under the search term Ariel HaNavi. But if you prefer to watch your theology, check out my YouTube channel. Subscribe to my YouTube channel and click the bell for notifications. New content is added weekly or even daily.